Hello and hola a todos. My name is Elba Moise and my pronouns are she, her, they, them, or si estamos hablando en el español, ella or AX, and I'm a doctoral candidate as well as an instructor in the College of Education, and I'm an instructional consultant at the Center for Teaching and Learning. And in this video, I'll be sharing a quick overview of the mid-quarter course feedback process and how it's a tool to understand student perspectives on what aspects of the course are helping them learn and what aspects of the course are not helping them learn and how can that be improved. And so having that feedback from students allows instructors to make changes or adjustments that improve and ultimately support student learning and success during the course rather than at the end of the term. I will also be discussing how including metacognition prompts in your mid-course quarter feedback can increase students' awareness of their own learning and thinking processes. Doing this gives them the opportunity to also consider their role in the learning process. The mid-quarter feedback process begins with deciding, okay, what questions do you as the instructor want to ask, and then creating your survey. And then next is introducing the mid-quarter feedback process to the students before and during class time and explaining how the process works and its purpose. The next step is creating time and space during class time, whether that's asynchronous or synchronous, for students to complete their survey. Afterwards, you can assess the feedback or their responses and noting themes and what changes you'll make and which you won't and why. And to close the loop, you discuss the responses and feedback with the students during the next class session. If it's live or if the class is asynchronous, you could do that via short Canvas video recording or Canvas announcement. Let them know what changes you'll make and why, as well as why you won't or can't make certain changes that they suggested. This process engages students in their own learning, and it also gives you, the instructor, the opportunity to discover what are some elements of the course that students find effective and whether they understand that connection among elements of the course. Metacognition refers to the thinking processes, and it happens when we analyze and we assess a task that we've done, and we're able to then evaluate the strengths and the weaknesses and then make plans, make goals for a new approach, and apply those strategies for improvement, and then to be able to reflect upon that. So this is a cyclical process, and research shows that metacognitive strategies can support student academic success. I've used Google Forms to collect mid-quarter feedback responses from my students, which I make it anonymous, so they're able to offer anonymous responses, in which I set aside time during synchronous class meetings to have students complete it. I also let them know why I'm taking the time as the instructor from class to get their perspectives so I can make changes that support their learning experience. And so I preview for them that I'll make some changes that are feasible based on the suggestions, but not all of them. And here are some metacognitive prompts that create opportunities for students to specifically reflect on their learning strategies, and their role in their own learning processes. So creating opportunities, again, for them to reflect on what are they doing, or what are some things that they could be doing differently or better that will support their learning and success in the course. What I would notice after looking at students' responses is that students are naming some of the things that they weren't doing so well, but that they could change and do a little bit differently with tools and resources that they already had access to, such as taking better notes, improving their time management, and showing up more to student hours when they had questions. And I also did notice that more students started showing up to student hours after doing the mid-quarter feedback. And after students have completed the form, it's important that, you know, after you've had a chance to look at the responses and decided, okay, where and what's feasible, what changes can you make, put aside asynchronous class time to talk with the students about their feedback and thanking them and explaining what changes you can and cannot make and why. Using mid-quarter feedback helps us in gathering information about the student learning experience, and it also provides an opportunity for metacognition, which can support you as an instructor by providing you with data that can inform possible changes that you might be able to make during the course. And also, students enjoy the opportunity to be able to provide feedback that might lead to some changes. They also find it useful whether their perspectives are representative. And finally, using mid-quarter feedbacks tend to improve end-of-course evaluations for instructors. Thank you very much. Muchísimas gracias. You all take care. Best of luck.